Shalom, everybody. Rabbi Jessica Graf, together, Cantor, Toby, Glaser, Rabbi Abby Phelps, and Zach Medea. We thank you so much, Zach. We are back together from all of our different homes and locations. I would just encourage, in case you've forgotten Zoom etiquette, I would encourage, please, everyone to be muted, which it looks like we are. And also, those of you who are at home who have pictures off, if you're willing to turn them on, we love seeing you. We love being together, even if you're in your bathrobe, or especially if you're in your bathrobe. That's excellent. Just join us however you are. It's really nice to see you. Oh, Roz came right on schedule. There we go. Let's see if she's wearing a bathrobe. I don't know. Hope you all had a lovely day yesterday, relaxing and eating something yummy and spending a little bit of time with wonderful people in your life, in person or on Zoom or on the phone, just connecting to people. And it's really nice to be together tonight to connect. I'd like to invite Christina Jefferson, who I see out there in top right box on my first line, to welcome us on behalf of the Board of Trustees.
Well, Shabbat Shalom, everybody. Rabbi said, I am Christina Jefferson. I'm a member of the board, along with a couple of other things. So if you've ever gotten an annual fund notice from me, it is, I always say that Thanksgiving is not my favorite holiday, less about the fact that I'm a vegetarian, but also because I am very proud of all of my identities, and I am, I'm a very proud member of one of my identities being Native American, and so it's a little bit of a problematic holiday. But I will say that what I love about it is something that is a part of my other identities, which is as a member of the LGBTQ community, LGBTQ plus community. I have always loved Friendsgiving. It is a time when those of us who don't have a lot of family and friends always get a chance to hang out with our friends, our chosen family. And I consider this to be part of that chosen family. And so I am so very happy and excited to see so many faces that I know during this day after that holiday. Something else I'm extremely thankful for is just a little bit of justice that we found out about this week. And I will say, as we know, the arc of justice, it bends, and it bended a little bit more towards justice this week. So with all of that, I want to say thank you. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for being a part of that chosen family, and Shabbat Shalom.
Thank you so much. Yes, I feel like sometimes at this time of year, especially during the pandemic, when we feel pretty isolated anyway, what a great privilege to be able to just be together and see people that we know, or maybe we don't yet know, and just kind of send hugs virtually. I didn't know that part of your ethnic background or compilation was Native American. What is your connection to the Native American? How?
My grandmother was only Irish and Native American, which is kind of a funny thing. But in all of part of my compilation is in the Virginia area. My family was mostly just Native American and Black. And so therefore, it's just a really interesting history that I'm learning more and more about, and we've always been proud of our Native American heritage. And so I am very proud of that, and very proud that we were able to give some money. One of our things that we do is we always give money to some Native American organization on Thanksgiving every year.
That's so cool. Do you know a lot about your, not to put you on the spot, but it's just fascinating to hear this. Do you know a lot about your specific Native American connections? Do you know what tribes or what areas?
Yes, my background is specifically the last name Christian is actually my from the background that I have, and it is actually one of the very first Native American tribes that actually converted to Christianity, which is why my great grandmother's last name was Christian, and that actually has some ties to President Tyler, and it is it also happens to also have been like Pocahontas's tribe, so it's a lot of. Because of the part of Virginia that my family is from, it's a lot of history. So
that's so cool. Thank you so much for sharing that about your family with us. And we all come together from all of the places that brought us here, which is wonderful and makes our community so rich and so special and so unique. So it's wonderful to hear about that as we prepare ourselves to enter into Shabbat. If you have Shabbat candles, please will you put them somewhere so we can light together as the cantor leads us in the blessing. If you have a siddur at home, we'll begin with the blessing on page 2.
Yes, unfortunately, with the electrical cords everywhere, I do not have candles. It was too much to set up. So, Zach, if there are any candles we are able to spotlight while I'm doing this blessing, that would be wonderful. Otherwise, let's all take in Shabbat and close our eyes. Using our mental candles.
And there we go. Chris and Janet, I see some beautiful.
Do we have some beautiful candles with Chris and Janet? Can we get that spot lit, Zach? Beautiful. And actually, I don't want to put you on the spot, Chris, but since you're lighting, would you like to chant for us or Janet? Oh, sorry, you're still muted. Let's... Zach, were we able to get them unmuted? There we go. Perfect.
There we go. Now I have to light one. Can you hold that? I have to light another set of matches here.
Yeah, multitasking. It's,
this was my grandma's.
Oh, beautiful.
Yeah. So it's very special.
Hmm. That's a beautiful, beautiful set of Shabbat candle holders.
Here we go. Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech ha'olam, asher kedishanu b'mitzvotav, v'tzivanu l'hadlik ner shel Shabbat.
Amen. Yashu koach, thank you. And such beautiful, elegant candle holders. Sure, your grandmother would be very proud that they are getting Shabbat usage.
Yeah. She'd be surprised that they're being held up on Zoom. thank you. That's so beautiful. We'll continue on page 20. And I'm just noticing that Zach actually put a link to the online prayer book. If you're looking for it, it's in the chat. Feel free to follow along. Page 20 as we welcome the angels of Shabbat with the Chadodi.
Lecha Dodi Likrat Kala. Shabbat nekabela lecha dodi lekrat kala tenei Shabbat nekabela shamor zachor bediburcha yishmianu el hameyucha Adonai echad o shemo echad Shem Tiferet Velit Hila Lecha Dodi Likrat Kala Penei Shabbat Nekabela Lecha Dodi Likrat Kala Penei Shabbat Nekabela Likrat Shabbat Lecho Venecha במחשבת תחילה לך דודי לקראת קלה בני שבת נקבלה לך דודי לקראת קלה בני שבת נקבלה את Kitorari, Kitorari, Kiva Ore, Kumi Ori, Ori Ori, Shida Beri, Kevod Adona, Alaich Nigla. Kala bene Shabbat nekabela nechadoti nekrat kala bene Shabbat nekabela. We rise to greet the Shabbat angels. Boi v'shalom ateret bala gam b'simcha uvtzochola. Tochemune am segula boi chala boi chala lecha dodi nekrat kala bene Shabbat nekabela lecha dodi nekrat kala bene Shabbat.
Beautiful. We remain standing if you're standing or facing in a sacred direction for Baruch Hu on page 28.
Ya da da da. Ya da 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 da, 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 ya da 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 da. Baruch Hu et Adonai Hamevorach. Baruch Adonai HaMevorach Le'olam Va'ed Le'olam Va'ed Yadai-dai-dai-dai 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 Yadai dai dai dai, yadai dai dai dai, yadai dai dai dai, yadai dai dai dai.
We turn to page 32. Praise to you, Adonai, who loves your people Israel. Baruch at Adonai, Ohev Amo Israel.
Ahavat olam bet Yisrael, amcha ahavta. Torah u'mitzvot, hukim u'mishpatim, anu limadeta. Al ken Adonai Eloheinu, b'shochbeinu ve'kumeinu. Nasiach bechukecha Venismach bedivrei toratecha Uve mitzvotecha Leolam vae Ki hem chayenu Veorech yameinu Uvahem Yomam Valaila. I believe we have a cameo appearance.
We have a special guest tonight, Zachary Graf, who is 5 years old, and he's been practicing the Shema in studio in Tefillah. So he's going to lead us in Shema.
Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Yehah, Adonai Yehah. Shema Israel, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai autograph.
Beautiful. Thank you, Zach. Wow.
An autograph.
Now is autograph, and she has been working on Dea Hafta. So she is going to lead us in the second part of the Shema.
Okay,
go ahead.
Adonai Aloheha, Harvarim Anochim Hayom Vashinantam Vanecha, Vidivartabam, Vashiv Techa, Vivetecha, Ublak Becha, Vaderech, Ushach Becha, Ufkumecha, Shartam Leo, Aliadecha, Behayula Tota Fot, Ain Einecha.
Uchtav Tam.
Almas is over Techa, Uvisharecha. Man, tis karu, sitam, ekomitotai, betam kedoshim, lalawehan. Ani, Adonai, lalawehan. Asher hote, tietam, means eret, means rhyme, leot lahem, lalohim. Ani, Adonai, lalawehan.
Adonai, lalawehan, emet yashokoach. Wowie, so good.
So we will continue with the service on page 40 as we thank God for all of the miracles in our lives. It feels very appropriate on this Thanksgiving weekend to be able to have a Jewish prayer that recognizes so many miracles around us. Page 40.
Absolutely. And we are coming up to the miracle of acknowledging fried food. So let's use our famous melody. Micha mocha ba'elim Adonai, Micha mocha nedar ba'kodesh, Nora tehilot osefele, Nora tehilot.
What comes next in just a couple of days. We'll set our own intention, each of us, as we join together in these words individually, but collectively also, as we ask God to help us open up our lips to say the things that we really need to say and to prepare ourselves to express gratitude and all of the other emotions in our lives. We'll turn now to page 43 as we ask first for peace and shelter with the words of Hashkivenu and continue on to ask God for shalom for the entire world. Baruch at Adonai haporesu kat shalom aleinu ve'al kol amo Yisrael ve'al Yerushalayim. Blessed are you, Adonai, guardian of Israel, whose shelter of peace is spread over us, over all your people Israel, and over Yerushalayim, your sacred city of peace.
Amen. Hashkivenu Adonai Eloheinu l'shalom, l'shalom, v'ha'amidenu shomreinu l'chayim. Ufros aleinu sukat shlomecha, ufros aleinu sukat shlomecha. Amen. Shelter us beneath your wings, O Adonai. Guard us from all harmful things, O Adonai. Keep us safe throughout the night, till we wake with morning's light. Teach us, God, wrong from right. Amen. 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 Amen.
We come together, we think about all of those in our hearts, in our lives, in our community, who are in need of our prayers, who are not feeling wholeness on this Thanksgiving weekend, who are needing our love for wholeness of body and wholeness of spirit. We pray for a refuah shleima, which means a complete recovery. And sometimes we know that is impossible for our bodies. We ask God for shleimut, for peace, and for a sense of completeness and support as we send our love and our prayers out to so many. In our community on this Shabbat, we are thinking of the healing of Shoshana Hannah Asher, Sharon Carmen, Jeremy Frick, Michael Gaines, Nikiko Wong, William Kurian, Monica Levin, Carolyn Reznikoff, Agnes Rothlett, Annette Wiener, and all of the other people that you lovingly put in the chat or whose names you say out loud. We'll join together on page 253 as we pray for their wholeness.
Mi sheberach avoteinu mekor habracha lavoteinu, may the source of strength who blessed the ones before us help us find the courage to make our lives a blessing, and let us say Amen. Mi sheberach imoteinu mekor habracha lavoteinu, bless those in need of healing with refuah shleima, the renewal of body, the renewal of spirit, and let us say
God, we ask you to help us to be inspired by this community, this group of friends, people we know, people we don't yet know, who are part of our identities and part of the makeup of our lives, as we are supported by one another and support one another, even in times when we sometimes feel separated or isolated during this pandemic that just seems to go on and on. We find comfort and support in being together. So as we prepare ourselves to say the words of the Amidah beginning on page 46, we are reminded of the power of minyan, of being together in community. When you feel ready to really open your heart and open your lips, please stand if you're able to stand, or turn to page 46 so that we can join together in these words. Page 46, yes, asking God to help us really pray with Kavana.
Ya da 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 ya da 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 ya da 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 ya da 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 Adonai sefatai tiftach ufi yagid tehilatecha Adonai open up my lips that my mouth may declare your praise ya da 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 baruch ata adonai Eloheinu, Elohei Avotenu ve'imotenu, Elohei Avraham, Elohei Yitzchak, Elohei Yaakov, Elohei Sarah, Elohei Rivka, Elohei Rachel, Elohei Leah, Ha'el Hagadol, Hagibor ve'hanora, El Elyon, Gomel Chasadim Tovim, Ve'konei Hakol. וזוכר חסדי אבות ואימהות, ומביא גאולה לבני בניהם, למען שמו באהבה, מלך עוזר ומושיע ומגן. ברוך אתה, אדוני, מגן אברהם ועזרת שרה. אתה גיבור לעולם, אדוני, מחיי הכל אתה, רב להושיע. משיב הרוח ומוריד הגשם, מחלקל חיים בחסד, מחיי הכל ברחמים רבים, סומך נופלים ורופא חולים, ומתיר אסורים, ומקיים אמונתו לשני עפר, מי חמוך בעל גבורות, ומי דומה לך, מלך ממית ומחיה, ומצמיח ישוע, ונאמן אתה לחיות הכל. ברוך אתה, אדוני, מחיה הכל. אתה קדוש ושמך קדוש, וקדושים בכל יום יהללוך סלע. ברוך אתה, אדוני, האל הקדוש. We take a few moments for silent prayer. Ose shalom bimromav uyaase shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael ve'al kol yoshvei tevel Ose shalom bimromav hu yaase shalom aleinu ve Israel ve'al kol yoshvei tevel.
Shabbat Shalom. I hope that you have had or are still having a satisfying Thanksgiving experience, whatever that means to you. For me, this year, it has meant traveling to LA to visit with my brother, Ben, his partner, Tara, and their somehow simultaneously adorable and mildly creepy Sphinx cat, Shmuley. He is at Shmuley_Sphinx on Instagram, in case you're interested. In between catching up with each other, playing with Shmuley. Oh no, Shmuley's arrived. Hello, Shmuley. Hello, beautiful kitty. Oh, you can't see him. There he is. Okay, I'm giving Drash. I should really stop this. sorry, my brother came in with Shmuley. In between catching up with each other and playing with Shmuley and eating lots of delicious things, we have also been watching some movies together. So yesterday, after putting it off for nearly a decade, I finally capitulated to my brother's many requests that I watch Cloud Atlas, the Wachowski sisters' sprawling 3-hour film about a group of souls who are quasi-reincarnating and interacting with each other across 6 centuries. Long story short, I liked Cloud Atlas, despite its faults, of which there are arguably quite a few. It is a polarizing film. Critics mostly either loved it or hated it, but I find myself somewhere in between, agreeing with Adam Frank's assessment in his review for NPR. He wrote, "Cloud Atlas is about big ideas expressed through small stories. At its worst, it becomes maudlin in its sentimentality. At its best, it becomes epic in its vision of human evolution on both the personal and cultural levels." One of the big ideas Cloud Atlas explores is the power and limitations of human agency. Cloud Atlas believes fervently that people can change and grow, that teshuvah, repentance, is always possible, and that everything each of us does matters, not just to us, but to the entire human family of which we are a part. Sonmi, a sort of messianic figure in the movie, declares at one point that our lives are not our own. We are bound to others, past and present, and by each crime and every kindness, we birth our future. I actually believe that this sentiment is shared by this week's Parsha, Vayeshev. Vayeshev marks the beginning of the Joseph cycle, the epic tale that follows Joseph on a roller coaster ride from beloved son to loathed brother, from abject prisoner to exalted public official, from family schism to heartfelt reconciliation. This year, as I was reading through the Parsha, I was struck by how profoundly a handful of relatively minor actions taken at the beginning of Joseph's story affect the narrative that unfolds. I'd like to explore a few of those actions, beginning with one by Joseph's brother, Judah. Judah is one of my favorite figures in Torah. He is eminently relatable, making both some very good and some very bad choices. And he is an excellent role model for teshuvah, admitting openly on more than one occasion that he has done wrong and doing the work needed to repair what he has damaged. Judah also plays a pivotal role in the beginning of Joseph's story. Their father, Jacob, has made no secret of the fact that Joseph is his favorite, and the brothers understandably resent him for it. Ultimately, they grow so enraged by Joseph's status and by his dreams of holding dominion over them, which he rather unwisely shares with them, that they somewhat less understandably decide to murder him. After the brothers throw him in a pit and pause to have a meal and consider what to do next, Judah jumps in with a suggestion. He says, "What is the profit if we kill our brother and cover up his blood? Let us go and sell him to the Ishmaelites, but our hands shall not be upon him, for he is our brother, our flesh." The Torah tells us explicitly that his brothers do listen to him, and shortly thereafter, we see them sell Joseph to some passing traders. It seems to me that in this moment, Judah has done an excellent job of reading the room and finding an effective pretense for protecting his brother. His suggestion allows his brothers to take out their fierce anger against Joseph in a satisfying way while still preserving Joseph's life. If we read Judah generously, we can see him as someone who is desperate to intervene on his brother's behalf, but feels compelled to wait for a suitable opening, and then cleverly works within the mentality of the group in order to mitigate the harm they will do. Judah is not, however, the first one to stand up to the group while passions are still running high. That distinction goes to Reuben, Joseph's eldest brother, who overhears his brothers plotting to kill Joseph and immediately protests. He says to them, "Do not shed blood. Throw him into this pit, which is in the desert, but do not lay a hand on him." He then disappears from the story, resurfacing only after the brothers have already sold Joseph into slavery and protesting once more against their callous actions. Reuben's temporary disappearance might itself be another expression of protest, or perhaps an attempt to get away long enough to come up with a better long-term strategy for protecting his brother, as the Torah tells us is his intention. Both Reuben's and Judah's interventions prove essential in sending Joseph forth on his highly consequential adventures and misadventures. Reuben's admittedly imperfect stopgap measure of throwing Joseph into a pit is the first critical step in saving Joseph's life. And then later on, having had a chance to consider the possibilities, or perhaps having found his conscience, Judah steps in and does what he presumably believes is necessary to save his brother. Without Reuben's courageous protest and Judah's shrewd suggestion, not only would Joseph's life have been different and much shorter, but the trajectory of the entire Jewish experience would have been radically different. Joseph would not have ultimately risen to power in Egypt, and the rest of the Israelites would never have followed him there, seeking the food he was able to provide during famine. Our foundational narrative of descending into slavery and oppression in Egypt and being redeemed through the Exodus would never have occurred. And today, we still need Judas. We need people who can recognize wrongs, take the time needed to assess them, and then wait for the opportune moment to fully address them. And even more so, we need Reubens, people who intercede when it matters most, no matter the risk, and even if they're not yet sure of the best course of action. Reuben's action took real guts. He faced down an angry mob intent on killing, and suggested an alternative course which, while not ideal, kept Joseph alive long enough for Judah to come up with a feasible plan. When we see injustice, it can be tempting to hesitate, to wait to respond until we have thoroughly assessed the situation and considered all the angles, and this kind of reflection is valuable, but we cannot let it inhibit us from stepping in to protect vulnerable people in acute distress. We need short-term and long-term solutions. And we need to grant each other the freedom to speak up passionately at key moments, even when our thoughts are not yet fully composed. We must do what Pirkei Avot teaches, judge one another lekaf zechut, on the side of merit, giving one another the benefit of the doubt that when we speak out, we do so not in order to be difficult or to stroke our own egos, but because we see injustice and suffering and we feel compelled to alleviate them. And I think most importantly, we need to remember that every one of us really does matter, and that each one of us has the power to do things, even seemingly small things, that change the course of history. Pirkei Avot also counsels us to run to do a seemingly minor mitzvah just as eagerly as we would to do a major one, because we never know what the consequences will be. Parshat Vayeshev shows this principle in action. Reuben and Judah may have thought that they were preventing a singular injustice or saving a single life. But in reality, they were setting up a narrative that would span centuries and touch billions of lives. May we each combine the best of Reuben and Judah, being ready to stand and be counted when it matters most, and to plan for how to create a more just world going forward. And may we never forget that in Sonmi's words, we are bound to others, past and present, and by each crime and every kindness, we birth our future. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, now is the time to share with one another our simchas, our joys, our joyous occasions. So if you are experiencing a joyous occasion, if you are with family whom you don't usually get to see, if you got to eat something amazing yesterday or today, because sometimes leftovers are better, if anything else that's exciting is going on in your life, please feel free to put it in the chat and share it with us. I will say it has been quite a joy for me to get to visit my family and to visit that adorable cat you saw before. and to discover that I do not seem to have an allergic response to him, which is a great triumph. let's see. Ah, yes. Luke says it's his birthday on Monday. So happy birthday, Luke. And Monique got to go to a Thanksgiving dinner. Ah, so Monique got to have her first Friendsgiving. So congratulations to everybody who had an excellent Friendsgiving. I've had some really good ones in the past myself. And and my brother is in a room adjacent to me with an adorable cat. Very good. Well, an honor. Cantor Toby, do you have one?
Christina Jefferson had a birthday on Tuesday. Anyone else? Any other birthdays this week?
Happy birthday, Christina.
Oh, do we have one down the bottom? Greg? No? Okay.
Mm-hmm. Well, happy birthday to everyone whose birthday has recently come or will come soon. And in honor of all of these simchas, we're going to join together in the Shehecheyanu in prayer.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Shehecheyanu v'kiyamanu v'higiyanu lazman hazeh. Amen.
Ooh, and Nancy has Satya with her, also very good news. We're going to move into the concluding portion of our service now. If you are following along in the flip book, you will want to turn to page 282 and rise and join us for Aleinu.
Aleinu l'shabeach l'adon hakol L'atet gedula l'yotzer b'reishit Shelo asanu kagoye haratzot Velo samanu kemishpachot ha'adama Shelo sam chalkeinu kahem Vegor aleinu kechol hamonam Va'anachnu koreim U'mishtachavim u'modim Lifnei melech מלכי המלאכים הקדוש ברוך הוא ונאמר והיה אדוני למלך על כל הארץ ביום ההוא ביום ההוא יהיה אדוני אחד ושמו 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 אחד.
Our thoughts now turn to those who have departed this earth, our own loved ones, those whom our friends and neighbors have lost, the martyrs of our people whose graves are unmarked, and those of every race and every nation whose lives have been a blessing to humanity. We think of many people inside and outside of our community this Shabbat, even though it is not time to say Kaddish for any of these folks yet. I am thinking this evening in particular of the six people who were killed in Waukesha earlier this week, and also of Stephen Sondheim, whom we learned just today passed away and who was a great light whom we will miss. For Shloshim, for the first 30 days of mourning, on this Shabbat, we remember Adrian Christine. If you are remembering someone for Shiva or Shloshim for the first 7 or 30 days of mourning, please share their name in the chat. The perpetual memorials in our community are Dr. Elliot Eisenberg, Judy Migdale, Leon Mervis, Harold Weiss, and Joanne May Weiss. On the Shabbat, we also observe the following yard sites, anniversaries of death. We remember Ernie Chiburo, Gertrude Epp, Sol Fateman, David Frost, David Hirschberg, Francis Katz, Ilusha Kakamovich, Sonia Kakamovich, Emmanuel Jesse Lazar, Amy Levin, Don Luce, Edward Merkel, Cecile Phillips, Jerry M. Pincus, Barbara Goldman Ruchim, Carol Smith, Ruben Sperber, Nancy Golan Thornburg, and Zelda Wine. And to those names, we add any names that you are thinking of in your own hearts and minds this evening or that you wish to share with us in the chat. In honor of all of those in our community whom we have lost, we rise together and we join in the mourner's Kaddish which you can find on page 294. Yitgadal v'yitkadash shmei rabba. B'yamma divra chirutei v'yamlich malchutei. B'chayechon uv'yamechon uv'chaye d'chol beit Yisrael. Ba'agala uvizman kariv v'imru amen. Yehe shmei rabba mevarach le'olam u'alamei almaya. Yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ar v'yitramam v'yitnaseh. V'yit hadar, v'yit aleh, v'yit halal, shmei d'kudsha, b'richu, le'ela min kol birchata v'shirata, tushpechata v'nechemata, da'amiran be'alma v'imru, amen. Yehe shlama rabba min shmaya, v'chayim aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael, v'imru, amen. Ase shalom b'mramav, hu ya'ase shalom aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'al kol yoshvei tevel, v'imru, amen. May the one who creates peace on high bring peace to us, to all Israel, and to all the world. And together we say, amen. Before we conclude our service, we're going to take just a moment for some announcements. Just as we are online on Zoom solely this evening, we will also be on December 24th and December 31st. So please be prepared to join us on Zoom once again for those Shabbatot, which all of these big holidays are all falling on Fridays this year. Also, in terms of joyous events that we can celebrate in person, please definitely come to the synagogue to join us for our Hanukkah Shabbat a week from today, next Friday, which will be, among other things, a celebration of installing our wonderful cantor, Toby Glaser, who has been with us for quite a long time, but we haven't had a chance to install him yet because COVID has been too much in the way. So please come and join us, and also bring your Chanukiah. We're gonna light everybody's Chanukiot up in front of the Bima. So feel free to do that too. Anything else, Rabbi Graf, Cantor, Glaser, that we wanna add?
Well, we're gonna be lighting Hanukkah candles together every night, starting Sunday night. So maybe Cantor, I don't know if you're coordinating this, but would you say something about it?
Yes, 6 p.m. Each night of Hanukkah, we will be gathering on Zoom. I believe the link is online. If not, I'm sure we will get an email out with that link. But 6 p.m., we will join together maybe for a song and a couple of blessings, and there will be different committees representing the synagogue.
Yeah, there are at least... Oop, go ahead.
I'm sorry, the link was in the email that had the link for tonight. So
great.
Check on in that email. Yes, definitely. Thank you.
And do try, I know we're on Jewish standard time, but we will do the blessings quite close to 6 p.m. So we'll give it a few minutes, but do try and make it online because they're going to be quick lightings.
Short and sweet ceremonies and opportunities to see each other. And exactly. There will be at least a couple of nights where some young people from studio, from our Bar Mitzvah cohort will help lead. So please join us when you can.
Also tomorrow morning, Rabbi Phelps will be leading Torah study at 9:15 on Zoom. So you can just leave your computer on.
There you go. Just leave it on until tomorrow. Well, if those are all of our announcements, then we're going to go ahead and move into the concluding portion of our service here with the Kiddush, blessing over the wine, which you can find on page 5. If you've got a nice wine glass or a perfectly normal wine glass or some grape juice with you, go ahead and hold it up so that we can all see, and the cantor will lead us in Kiddush.
Yes. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Bore Peri Hagafen. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kirshanu B'mitzvotav V'ratzavanu ושבת קודשו באהבה וברצון הנחילנו זיכרון למעשה וראשית כי הוא יום תחילה למקרא קודש זכר לציאת מצרים קיוונו בחרת ואותנו קידשת מכל העמים ושבת קודשך באהבה וברצון הנחלתנו. ברוך אתה אדוני מקדש השבת. אמן. לחיים.
לחיים. Lots of wine glasses and a few really very special looking Kiddush cups. Terry and Steve, and I saw a few others. If anybody has a story that they want to share with us about their Kiddush cup, would love to. Oh, Julie has a special one too. Does anybody have a story attached to your Kiddush cup? And Al, I saw Al Breslauer has one too. Anybody get one in an interesting place?
This was a bar mitzvah Kiddush cup, which has made it this far through grad school and across
wow.
across several continents, so it's still going strong.
Well done.
My children made mine. And the other side says Yom Tov, so you can, it's a double duty. But it's always, we had a lot of fun making it together at whatever, Terra Mia or whatever it was, back in the day.
I love it. Nice. So it's ceramic. Here's a ceramic.
It is ceramic.
So nice.
Thanks, Julie.
Terry, does yours have a story, or Al, or just beautiful Kiddush cups?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah.
I don't know anything really about this, but it comes from a part of our family with the surname Fisher, and
it's quite old. Yeah,
nice.
That's pretty cool. Well, speaking of having beautiful things in your homes, I'm sure some of you also have beautiful chalot. There are some people.
This is what we've really missed.
This is right. We want to see these chalot so that we can drool over them and be envious, even as we are still full of Thanksgiving food. So if you do have a nice looking challah, please feel free to hold it up.
Not only is yours nice looking, but ooh. I learned online that it really has a history too. Will you share that with us? Speaking of weaving together all of our family histories into one community, I loved what you wrote today.
Okay, so I actually put cranberries in it because sort of in honor of my late father-in-law who escaped from the Cape Verde Islands, and he came to the United States in 1918 as a contracto to work in the cranberry bogs at Cape Cod. So our family feels kind of connected to the cranberries. So.
Beautiful, thanks so much.
Thought they'd like it.
Ah, beautiful history. Thank you for sharing that with us. Well, in honor of that challah and all of the other beautiful ones, we'll say hamotzi together. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam hamotzi lechem min haaretz te'avon. Enjoy your challot. And speaking of honoring folks, we're going to end our service this evening with a song by the late, great Stephen Sondheim.
Wait, but before that, Roz, are you wearing your pink bathrobe? Because I think that I see a pink bathrobe. And
a blue one.
Oh, wow, double robe score. Amazing.
Nice. Okay, I didn't want to let that pass by us. So.
Never.
Just for you.
I love it. You have to wear it to the synagogue December 3rd for Cantor Toby's installation.
We can't. Please. We have our own family Hanukkah.
The menorah needs a robe. Yeah. So, yes, in honor of the late, great Stephen Sondheim, as many of you may know, his compositions are some of the hardest pieces in the music theater repertoire. So in addition to being an amazing composer, he really was quite a brilliant lyricist. And so I've chosen a piece for which he wrote the libretto, West Side Story, the piece Somewhere, which is a beautiful lyric and really almost a piece of liturgy, which I think is a song of hope in this difficult time. And here is Somewhere with lyrics by Stephen Sondheim. Zichrono Livracha. There's a place for us somewhere, a place for us, peace and quiet and open air. Wait for us somewhere. There's a time for us, someday a time for us, time to together with time to spare, time to learn, time to care. Someday, somewhere, we'll find a new way of living. We'll find a way of forgiving somewhere. There's a place for us, some dead man place for us. Hold my hand and we're halfway there. Hold my hand and I'll take you there. Someday, somehow, somewhere. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom, everybody.
I'm putting Shmuley's Instagram in the chat in case anyone wants it.
Shabbat shalom, everyone.
Shabbat shalom.
All right, I'm on mute.
Man.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
That was beautiful, Cantor. Thank you. That was beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Definitely generational.
Very beautiful choice. Thanks for singing that so sweetly. Thank you.
Thank you.
That was so beautiful. Thank you. Fantastic.
It was great to hear Christina's
heritage.
All
right.
I'll see you tomorrow morning.
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. See you in the morning.
See you quite a few of you tomorrow morning.
I know. You see me.
Rabbis, I was curious as I was doing Kiddush. What is there any rules about red wine? I used white tonight because it was open. Is there any specification that it should be red wine just so people know it's wine?
Is Rabbi Graf still here? Maybe not.
I hope white is okay.
I think it's fine.
I think it's fine. And I think somewhere there is some kind of preference expressed for red, but I may be making that part up.
I could see them saying, you know, just so everyone's certain that it's wine and no one can confuse it with, you know, grape juice or lemonade or whatever. But
yeah, there may be a thing like that, but for sure it's still like kosher and counts if it's I mean, as long as it's any kind of grape product, really works.
Excellent. So if you want a Chardonnay, it's totally fine.
That's right. Have your Chardonnay. All right. Shabbat shalom, everybody. See you.